And aren't they ignoring the externalities of a tax, like especially on younger Americans, the marginally employed,
absolutely,
people that the rich hire, that corporations hire? I mean, don't businesses first cut?
Absolutely. Of course they do. Look at the unemployment rate. It's the youth that have among the highest unemployment rates in the country, double digits among the youth. Look, when I was growing up, I worked at McDonald's, I detasseled corn, I did lots of different jobs. It was easy to get a job as a young person. It is harder and harder, and especially if you're coming out of college, it's even harder to get a good job within the field that you've chosen to study. This is because we are in a very difficult economy with high unemployment, and they just don't do the hiring. And if you're going to fire, most companies do so on a seniority basis, it's the young person that goes first.
So we're facing this debt ceiling, and we're starting to take a step forward with this, but I mean, everyone's saying that you're the one that's trying to push grandmother off a cliff.
Yeah, yeah, right?
With your plan and with the current plan being proposed by the House, are you really trying to push granny off a cliff,
no.
Or are liberals trying to push my generation off a cliff?
Well, liberals are actually pushing granny and your generation off a cliff. What I mean when I say that is, don't forget that the president does have a plan for Medicare. He passed it in law already. And his plan for Medicare is to take $500 billion from Medicare to spend on Obamacare, and then to put a board of bureaucrats, 15 bureaucrats appointed by the president starting next year, unelected, unaccountable, and their job is to ration Medicare. Their job is to put price controls on Medicare and to determine what seniors can and cannot get, what providers can and cannot do, and that is going to hurt and deny seniors the health care they need through Medicare. So he's already put in place a government rationing program for Medicare. We repeal the raid of the program, we repeal the rationing board, we save it, and we actually say, if you're on Medicare, we're gonna leave it alone, because you already retired. But for our generation, Medicare goes bankrupt in 9 years. It won't be there for us as it currently is standing. And so you gotta make reforms so that we can actually have something when we retire. And I would rather have power as an individual to select providers instead of being subject to the whims of some board of bureaucrats. And so I think patient-centered healthcare, those of us can be in charge of our healthcare, that to me is the secret to success, to saving this program. So we make Medicare solvent, we give people, younger people, more choices when they retire, it's something they can count on, and we don't change the program for people in and near retirement, unlike the Obama plan, which is to ration and raid the program.
So speaking of Medicare, which is, as you always say, is the biggest driver of our debt.
It is.
And Obamacare basically transfers wealth from young people to old people because of the price controls, like you mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
And we're talking in the context of the debt as well. It seems like government has turned extremely anti-youth.
Yeah.
What can young people do to help turn that around?
And that's what I hope young people get to realize. I think in the 2008 election, they voted for a great idea. They voted for a great feeling. They voted for a great slogan. Now that we've seen the details unfold, it is crystal clear that the government and the way it acts today is giving your generation, and I would argue my ex-generation, a lower standard of living. They're making America less competitive, less prosperous, less free, and they're taking away the sense we've always had of equal opportunity and upward mobility. That's what it's all about. You can make the most of your life if you apply yourself, and we want to have a system that makes it as easy as possible to you to do what you want to do with your life and reach your potential. With the kind of government, the interest, the taxes, the regulations, the stagnation that is coming because of policies that our government's doing today, that's not going to be the case. The tax rates on my kids, according to the Congressional Budget Office, the 10% tax rate for low-income people goes to 25%. Middle-income taxpayers pay a 66% tax rate, and the top-income tax bracket, which is what all those successful small businesses end up paying, goes to 88%. These aren't my numbers. These are what the Congressional Budget Office is telling us. That's the path that awaits us if we stay on the Obama plan, the Obama path. That, whatever you call that, that is not opportunity and growth for the next generation. That is not maintaining the American legacy of leaving the next generation better off. It's severing that legacy.
So if you had one last message to young people on why to be involved and what they can do, what would you tell them?
It's your future. Your future is on the ballot right now. Your future is being decided right now. How we go into this debt crisis, and we have one coming, the way in which we solve it will specifically determine the kind of country we are coming out of it, and whether or not you have the kinds of opportunities in your lifetime that your parents and grandparents had in theirs.
Congressman
it's just
Ryan,
that simple.
Congressman Ryan, we really appreciate you taking the time to talk to us.
Yeah, thank you. Appreciate it.